This place is walking, yeah. Get the jug and cut the rug. I said the joint is jumping. Listen, get your...
Okay, thank you all for coming out. Welcome to the Meeting House Theater Lab production of Talley's Folly by Lanford Wilson. We're thrilled to have Laura Whittenberger and Ben Russell here with us, both of them. Have great credits from shows across the country back when that was possible. But we're really thrilled to have them. I have forgotten their credits because there's so many of them. So I'm not going to say anything about that. But we are really happy that they're here. I just want to make the point of saying that they're in the same household, so they're not keeping social distance for this production, which is something you don't really see. Like when we did the Winter Harbor Music Festival production, myself and the soprano maintained a distance. So it's really quite refreshing to see theater that actually, as it was intended, not maintaining a distance. I really hope you enjoy it. The show is by donations. Anything helps. But we're just happy to have you here. So I hope you enjoy it.
Hey, tell me, we have 90 minutes here today without intermission, so if that means anything to any of you, you need to get a drink of water or something. Last summer, I took Sally home from a dance, and as we were talking up on the porch, we looked out onto the river, and we saw this silver flying thing rise up and zip off. We thought that the Japanese had landed some amazing flying machine, and so we rushed down here, and all we found was this boathouse. And that was enough. Now, we have, if everything goes well for me tonight, this should be a waltz. One, two, three, one, two, three. A no-holds-barred romantic story, and since I'm not exactly the romantic type, I'm gonna need the help from the whole Valentine. The woods, the willows, the vines, the twilight, the band. There's a band that plays across the river. Frogs, dogs, frogs, dogs, frogs and dogs. Can we get a dog? Fellas, a dog. Oh yeah. Now we got everything here we need. All of the river is all over here. You all are in the water. Sorry. But we could do this on a couple of folding chairs, but it's not bare. It's not run, it's not bombed out. It's run down. And that makes all the difference. Also, Valentine's need frou-frou. Are you all ready?
Matt?
This is a waltz, remember? One, two, three, one, two, three.
Are you out in the boathouse? I'm not coming in there if you're not there. You there?
No!
I swear, Matt Friedman, what the devil you think you're doing down here? Buddy said he'd run you off the property with a shotgun. And now, you know, I thought, good, maybe we're rid of you. And then I saw your car parked out there, and I didn't know what to do. And there you stand, wiping your glasses.
Well, the better to see you with, my dear.
I'm in no mood, Matt. Do not even begin with me.
Were you hiding up at your house behind the window curtains while I was out in the yard? You like to hide from me so much.
I got home 5 minutes ago. You know what time I get home from work? Rachel and Ida dropped me off front, and we heard Buddy cussing all the way out to the road.
Did you talk to your Aunt Charlotte? How did you know I'd be here?
I walked in that house exactly 30 seconds, and then Mama and Buddy lit in on me like I was 10 years old. screaming about this communist traitor infidel that I'd let in the house. Buddy said he'd run you off with a gun.
He did have a large two-barreled hunting gun with apertures like so.
If they knew you were still on the place, they'd have Cliffy on you.
Shh, you want the sheriff? All you have to do is keep on yelling. Your sister-in-law called the sheriff. He's probably up at the house right now.
Whatever possessed you to come down here and get in a fight with my brother?
Sally, I think we better either one of us take a walk and cool off. We can't both be angry right now.
What better happen is you better march yourself right back out to your car and drive back to St. Louis.
No, you see, the way they build these things nowadays, they require gasoline to really get them going, especially Plymouths.
Matt Friedman, you did not run out of gas.
You want to try? See if you can get it to catch.
If that isn't just typical.
That's what saves it, I think. I was just thinking that that was typical.
That car's gonna kill me. I'm a strong person, but that car is gonna do it. Not one time has that car gone from one place to another place without breaking down.
Sally, you don't castigate a man's car. A man's car reflects his pride in himself and his status in society. You castigate my car and you castigate me.
Well, good. And you may be full of hot air on most things, but you were right about that. That hay baler is a good reflection of you.
Boy, you get angry. You really are a mountain daughter. Where's the still? You told me there was a still down here.
Matt, I'm exhausted. I've been up since 5. I was at the hospital at 6:30. Now, I don't want to argue. The still was right over there. They busted it up. They broke it up.
Your dad get raided by Cliffy?
Cliffy wasn't sheriff then. McConklin was sheriff. He and Dad were half partners in the still. They tore it up for scrap after the repeal. Matt,
they were running liquor, were they?
Is the only thing keeping you here a gallon of gas for your car? Because there's a can out in the pump house.
You better wait till it gets darker if you're going to start stealing Buddy's gas.
You've alienated Buddy. You've nearly paralyzed Olive.
Olive, oh! I could not remember your sister-in-law's darn name! I was thinking pickled herring, I was thinking caviar, I was thinking boiled egg. I knew she was on a relish tray.
Why are you always barging in places?
No, ma'am. I wrote to you how many times I would be here today.
You barge into a person's home? You barge into where they work?
I called your house! I had a nice Missouri telephone chat with your Aunt Charlotte.
Aunt Lottie. Would invite the devil into the parlor for hot cocoa.
Only I was trying to talk with your father. That's the way I've been told things are done here in the South.
You're not in the South. You're in the Midwest.
Sally, I have been all over this country, and there is New York City, isolated neighborhoods of Boston, and believe me, the rest is all the South.
Well, will you just tell me what happened up there so I know how to handle them?
Sally, I know I told you I'd be down here this whole weekend, and I've been looking forward to it just as much as you have.
You are the most conceited, blind, deaf.
There's just no way. I have to be back in St. Louis tomorrow. We have a hearing on the Iceman and his horse.
On what?
And I wrote to you. The Iceman and his horse. We had him consecrated as a church, and that worked for a while, but then they caught on.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Churches don't pay taxes. We had him ordained. They didn't like that, so we set up a trust fund in the name of Daisy. They tell me horses can't hold trust. It was just sprung on us. But I have to be back in St. Louis tomorrow.
Will you just tell me what happened up there?
It was crazy of me to come down here, but I promised you.
Why was Buddy so angry?
Did you hear me? I only have tonight.
Will you please just...
Okay. Sally, it does not matter, but if it makes you happy, I came down here as I said I would. I parked my car, I walked up to the front door, your sister-in-law, from the relish tray, you said...
Olive!
I cannot remember that dang worms. Olive came to the door, shaking and wide-eyed, and she just, I say, oh, hello, my name is Matt Freeman. I wanted to come by this beautiful evening and have a chat with Mr. Talley, and she just stands there, doing her impersonation of a fish.
She did what?
You know, she's frozen, she can't speak at all, she goes...
It's not necessary to characterize everything.
I'm trying to tell this in a way that doesn't make me angry again.
Okay.
Finally, she swims off after having said absolutely nothing. Then your brother Buddy comes. Does
your entire family have such absurd names?
His real name's Kenny. We call him Buddy.
Kenny is his real name? This is somehow better for a grown man? Kenny Talley. Lottie Talley. Timmy Talley. Sally Talley! Your brother also does not know how to converse. Your brother speaks in rhetorical questions. You're Sally's Jewish friend, aren't you? What do you think you want here? Didn't you know that trespassing is against the law?
Oh, they're all such hypocrites and fools.
There was nothing hypocritical about it, believe me.
Well, you deserve it coming down here. I told you Dad said you weren't invited back.
So Buddy says, why don't you go off to the hospital to meet her there? And I said, well, I'll just wait out in the yard. And then he got his two-barreled hunting gun.
And Olive called the sheriff.
I'm admitting the yelling, the screaming, and the deprecating.
Who was yelling?
Well, there was your Aunt Charlotte yelling, this man came here to see me! And there was your mother yelling, you are not to see my daughter! And then there was Olive yelling, get back in the house! At everybody, at Olive, at Charlotte, at Buddy, at the dog who was barking. And there was Buddy's business friend in the yard protecting Buddy. He mostly said, you tell him, Buddy, you tell him, Buddy.
I'm not even going to apologize. You had it coming to you.
Oh, your aunt, your sister-in-law and your mother were protected in the screened-in porch. Protected from the mosquitoes and the communists and infidels.
I have absolutely got to get out of that place. But Rachel and Ida and I have been looking for an apartment in town for months.
Actually, you don't get mosquitoes here, do you? Rich people always know where to build their houses. With the wind always blowing and the river coming by, the mosquitoes don't nest here. Do mosquitoes nest? Does everything that lays eggs nest? Do fish nest? That's a funny thought.
Now don't try to make me feel good, Matt. It's not going to work. Fish spawn.
What do mosquitoes do?
I do not know what mosquitoes do. They breed.
You know, I bet you're right. See, I thought you'd be happy to see me. That's my trouble. I got no sounding board. I sit up there and in St. Louis, in a dusty old office, sneezing away, and I get to daydreaming. I start thinking, well, now, Matthew, what you ought to do is you ought to go down to them hills
please
and get
please don't do that. Don't make fun of the way we talk. Oh, everything you do, it's enough to make a...
creature cuss? A sailor blush?
I don't make fun of your accent. I don't see why you...
I have no accent. I've worked very hard and have completely lost trace of accent.
Very well.
So anyway, I get to daydreaming away up there, and I start thinking, well, Matthew, this Sally, she looks to be a good deal, Matthew. She showed you a good time. The least you could do is reciprocate.
That's supposed to be someone, I guess. That's not you.
What do you mean, someone? You
don't know Humphrey Bogart?
Well, we don't go to the pictures.
How did you know he was a movie actor? He could be Secretary of the Interior.
My grandmother knows Humphrey Bogart. She never been to a picture.
You don't castigate a man's imitation, Sal.
And the Secretary of the Interior has been Harold Ickes since Sitting Bull.
You don't go to the movies?
Pictures are an excuse to sit alone in the dark.
To sit together in the dark.
Not necessarily.
Well, you go?
I don't always go alone, no.
Now that's interesting.
Sometimes I go with some of the other nurses' aides from work.
It's a big business, isn't it? Caring for the wounded. It's a nice place for the boys to forget about the harsh realities of making a buck when they get out.
The boys we take care of have seen their share of harsh realities.
It's a very sunny building. The boys are all have a very sunny attitude. The nurses are very sunny. The doctors are very sunny. The nurses' aides are very sunny. You'd expect the whole place to go up in spontaneous combustion.
We try to be pleasant, yes. What would you have us do? Say, oh my gosh, you look horrible. I don't think you're going to make it through the night. Or, oh, you poor man, both hands missing and all you know is auto mechanics. You're never going to find a job you'll be happy with.
No, I wouldn't have you do anything.
You don't have to fake anything when we work with them. You see progress every day. Some of them will recover completely.
I wasn't criticizing. I admire it.
I was there when you barged in last spring. I wasn't home.
That was funny. When I spoke to the nurses, one of them said you were out sick, and the other said that you had gone to Kansas City to requisition more beds. Now... she was a very imaginative thinker, but under careful questioning, she was not a very good fibber.
So you drove all the way down to Springfield and all that way back for nothing.
It was not a wasted afternoon. I had the honor to be shown by a Negro private from California 25 different ways I could lose at the game of checkers. Plus, I had time to puzzle. Why would Sally tell everyone with whom she works that if this hairy Jewish man comes down like a crazy man to see her, that she tell everybody that she is away and Sally will hide in a closet?
I was working in the kitchen that day where visitors are not allowed. It was not necessary to hide.
With all the little nurses coming in every 10 minutes to say, "Well, I don't know, Sally. He's still up there. Looks like he intends to stay all day." Puzzles do not waste my time, Sally. I am very good at puzzles. I have great powers of ratiocination. I am a regular Sherlock. He was a terrible anti-Semite. He was a rather shallow and ignorant man. Did you know that?
I wasn't listening. I was trying to figure out what ratiocination
means.
Oh,
forgive me. I don't have a speaking vocabulary. I have a reading vocabulary. I don't speak much.
I haven't noticed the problem.
Weren't you always telling me to say something? Matt, why don't you talk more? Weren't you always asking me questions?
I retract everything I said last summer.
But unlike Sherlock, I am not quick. I am steady, and I stay at something. Like, it took me a long time to understand something as thick as me, and then going over the Sally in the closet puzzle, I decided what was needed was an on-the-spot investigation.
Matt,
so if you don't mind, I have a couple of questions I'd like to ask you.
There's no mystery.
Mystery isn't bad, Sally. Mystery is the spice of life.
Variety is the spice of life.
Well, variety has always been a mystery to me. You give me one thing and I can take it or leave it. Give me two and I can't decide. Give me three and I don't want any of it. Now,
I can't see why you cannot seem to get the message. You sound like a functioning human being, but there's a wire crossed or something.
A screw loose.
You are one total living loose screw. That much is certain. You have been away a solid year. The one time you come to hunt me down at the hospital, I refused to see you.
Not refuse, hid in the kitchen.
And you stayed up in that day room the entire blessed afternoon.
I was not made to feel unwelcome.
Not made to feel unwelcome? You do not have the perception that God gave lettuce. I did not answer but one of your letters. And in that one brief note, I tried to tell you in no uncertain terms that I did not want you to write me. You have sent me a near daily chronicle of the life in your office, the most mundane details of your accounting life. Why did you come back here?
It was a really wonderful way to begin the morning, writing Dear Sal. It cleared out my head, like reading the newspaper, only not so depressing. You see, I could just tell you about the intrigue of the office, mull over problems than I anticipated, and knowing you, you sort of spoke along with me. You're carefully thoughtful, rational judgment was a great boon to my disposition. It improved the weather. And the weather in St. Louis can take all the improvement it can get. I bet I made you laugh.
Not once.
No?
No, you did not.
That's a blow.
I knew you were trying to, but I didn't find anything particularly funny.
Well, not trying, but I thought you might. I thought you might.
Well, it wasn't like being away from you, that's for sure. Not at all.
Didn't you look forward to the mail just a little bit?
I dreaded every new day.
See, if I believed that, I'd leave.
I did gain a fondness for the calm respectability of Sunday.
Holidays must have been nice.
Holidays were a benediction.
Did you ever make that recipe I sent you? I didn't make it because I don't have an oven timer. I cook in the oven, I forget what I'm doing, I leave, I come back, and the apartment is terrible! I cook well, but I was...
I don't cook. Why don't you just walk up to the Barnetts? It's not that far. They'll give you some gas. You can get back into town.
Sally, you have no sense of nostalgia. No romance.
No, I do not. Not right now. I can't remember feeling less romantic.
Alone, together, in the dusk. I mean, this country, this countryside, it's so beautiful. Don't you think it's beautiful? Or when you live in it all the time, do you take it for granted?
Well, we know it's beautiful. Well, why wouldn't we appreciate it? There's got to be some compensation in the place. It's not particularly fertile. It's rocky. It's got poor drainage. It's all hills.
How can it have poor drainage if it's all hills?
The hills have nothing to do with drainage. Water has to seep in the ground, not run off. It's the summer's just a dry, and the crops just curl up in the fields. Spring is a cycle of floods, and winter is too cold and too damp.
But it's beautiful! Oh, gotten you! Oh, wow. Goes right through! Not exactly what you'd call seaworthy. River-worthy. When was the last time anyone was down here? Besides you and me, or besides you trying to get away from your house, and besides you and me coming down here last summer?
I wouldn't know.
Thought to maybe fix the place up.
Well, nobody has any use of it anymore. Couldn't get materials now if you wanted to.
Fancy place to let rot away.
Nobody even knows who spent all that much time to build some crazy place like this. It's not even grand, it's just silly. Is it not silly? It must have broken a lot of jigsaw blades.
Uncle Whistler.
What?
Everett Talley. He built the boathouse in 1870. He built Follies all over town. He wanted to build a gazebo up by the house, but Grandpa said it was a frivolity, so he built a boathouse.
And made it look like a gazebo?
Well, that's what he wanted to do in the first place. He did the bandstand in the park across the river. Town didn't want it, but he'd seen it in a picture somewhere, so he went right over and built it. They tried to stop him, but he went right on. Said they could tear it down as soon as he'd finished. He painted it maroon and pink and gold. Said, now tear it down. Eventually, they used it for high school band concerts.
Sounds like a frustrated guy.
Not at all. Why does everything have to be so cynical? He wasn't in the least frustrated. He was a happily married man with 7 kids. He made toys, tap dancing babies and whirligigs. He got pleasure out of making things for people. He did exactly what he wanted to do. He was the healthiest member of the family. Everybody in town knew him. They called him Whistler.
Because he was the artist of the family?
Because he sang and whistled. He used to go stomping through the woods singing, Una furtiva lagrima, at the top of his lungs. Nobody outside the Talleys knew what he was singing about, so they all called him crazy, but he certainly wasn't frustrated.
Are those skates? My, somebody had big feet. Do you skate?
No.
Me too. Did you ever skate on the sidewalk when you were young?
There isn't a sidewalk closer than a mile and a half in town.
Me too. All the other kids had skates, fly past me, knock me down. I was only 5, but
some memories linger.
In St. Louis?
There was a lake, and in the winter it was frozen solid and people would skate on it. I once borrowed another kid's skates, nearly broke my neck. It was to be expected.
I'm not exactly what you would call a beautifully coordinated individual.
Don't put those on.
There's a roller rink in Lebanon. Seems to be the principal recreation around here.
Folks come up from Springfield.
Fellas and their dates?
Girls, looking for soldiers.
Everyone seems to be having a good time. All that drinking and all that skating, I'd get sick.
They do.
You go?
I went once, Matt. I didn't like it. Don't stand up in those. You'll go right through the floor.
No. It's all a matter of balance.
For crying out loud.
Unfortunately, I have almost no sense of balance at all.
How do you start? You just push off and then you glide?
Well, you could push off. You don't have to. I suppose you could.
Eventually, you come to a standstill. How do you keep going?
Well, you take steps. Step, push, and you glide on that foot. All your weight on that one foot.
How do you keep all your weight on this foot?
Well, the other foot has to come up.
How does the other foot come up?
Lift it. For God's sake, lift it.
Oh, okay. What, one foot?
Okay. Now, when you're gliding on that one foot, before you start to slow down, you lean all your weight onto the other foot.
What's to catch me if I lean all my weight off this foot?
The other foot, you got too stupid.
I am awkward, Sally. I am not stupid.
Well, put this foot down.
That's now. Much better.
Now you have to lift the other foot up.
I know, and glide on that. Mm-hmm. What's to keep skaters from getting tangled up?
Well, they're synchronized.
Well, I'm not going to worry about what you do. You'll just confuse me. La 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 la. La 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 la. La 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 la. Bop bop bop.
Oh, Matt, come on, not so loud.
La 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 la. La 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 la. Bop bop bop.
Come on, Matt, they'll hear you out the house across the river.
I'm having an old-fashioned skate with my gal.
I'm not your girl, Matt. Don't. It's ridiculous.
No, 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 don't let go. We're coming to the end of the pond.
I'm going to go for the gasoline for your car.
No, Sally, I'm going too fast. I can't turn. Sally, help. I'm going to crash. The trees are looming up in front of me. Big trees, oak trees, fir trees. They're black against the snow, firelight flickering on them from the campfire. They're frozen solid and deadly. It's the end of a brilliant career. Sally, I'm going to crash. No! Oh, 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 oh,
oh, Sally, I'm
in serious. Come on, Sally, where are you going?
I'm going for your gas.
Come on, I can't chase after you in these.
Well, good. I'm good and sick of you chasing after me, Matt.
Sally, just don't. Oh, oh my God. Oh,
oh. Oh, God, Sally, I'm stuck. I can't.
What did you hurt? Where did you hurt?
I know, I think I'm okay, but that thing fell down on me. I don't think I'm injured. Maybe my head? Look at you, standing over me with your arms crossed. Well, I'm not, there is one problem. I'm sort of stuck here. I can't get out. Can you give me a hand?
They must have heard you in the park. They must have heard you all the way across the river.
I was having a good time. Skating is good exercise.
I can't. You're too big. You're not helping.
I'm helping.
You'll have to get out by yourself. What a baby.
Well, I'm not in an uncomfortable position. It's not bad down here. My ego's a little bruised, but other than that...
You're not going to be so comfortable once you get your foot snake bit.
Oh, my God. You know just the right things to say, don't you? No, it looks like I'm not injured.
No, not even bruised. The wood's too rotten to hurt me, even.
Could have scraped yourself on a rusty nail and got blood poisoning.
No, I had a tetanus shot before coming down here. That's what you have to do if you want to go fishing. I read that. In case you get your finger pricked on a rusty hook. Most painful thing I ever paid to have done to me. Were you serious about snakes?
Oh, copperheads, water moccasins, cottonmouths. I mean, they won't prey on you, but I suppose if you stuck your foot right in a nest, they wouldn't like it.
Snake's nest? Had you told me about the snakes last summer before we went down here, there would never have been an affair between Sally and Matt.
There was no affair.
Of course there was an affair. How many times in 7 days did I come down to see you?
I don't know.
Seven. I got my voice hoarse trying to speak over that dance band. Mm-hmm. I could hardly speak all week long.
Kids nowadays, they like it so loud that they don't have to think.
I don't blame them.
Neither do I.
You didn't mind me talking to you on the porch of that Shriner's Mosque?
I didn't mind talking to you. I didn't mind you driving me home. I didn't even mind changing the tire.
I thought we made a good team. Most girls would have stayed in the car. You at least helped hold the flashlight.
Held the flashlight?
Well, and told me how to change a tire.
And lit matches so you could see when the flashlight batteries burned out. I could have done it much faster myself. Now, what I minded was the very next evening having to walk 2 miles when the carburetor failed.
I told you to wait in the car. I told you not to come.
Well, what's somebody going to say? Me sitting there in the car alone on a road where lovers park, where I have never been before in my life, not even in school.
Well, I was trying to hitchhike us a ride, but every time a car came by, you hid in the bushes. I'm looking around for you, and all the drivers think I'm drunk and swerve into the other lane. You almost caused 3 head-on collisions that night.
Well, aside from that night, the other times I saw you were a lot of fun. Except maybe that time you came to dinner.
I am not responsible for your family. That was your idea.
They're all saying all the time what a crazy old maid Emma Goldman I'm becoming. I wanted to show them how conservative and ignorant I really am.
You are not conservative. You are not ignorant. And believe me, Emma Goldman was no old maid.
Well, between being what they consider out and out anti-American, being over 40 years old and having a beard, you made a grand hit with Mom and Dad, let me tell you.
I could tell.
You left the house and Dad said, "That man is more dangerous than Roosevelt himself."
What he was hoping was that I would be a proper Christian suitor to take Crazy Sally off their hands.
No. At least they've stopped hoping for that. That's something.
Sally, where are you going? We were getting on so well.
We are not getting on so well.
Sally, you're scared. And I'm scared. But we both have to realize that we are going to deal with this before either of us leaves.
There's nothing to deal with, Matt.
No, there is quite a lot to deal with. We can't have it both ways. You can either come down here to chase me away, or you can put on a pretty dress. But you can't put on a pretty dress to come down here and chase me away. I've seen you in your work uniform.
I changed out of my uniform at work tonight.
Because you knew you would see me after work?
I didn't know you'd be down here. I thought I'd come and listen to the band.
You came down here because this is where we came last summer.
This is my place. I come here every day.
Okay, fine. I'll believe that. You come down here to escape your family, maybe get a cigarette to unwind because you can't smoke at the house, maybe have a nip from a whiskey bottle you have hidden around here somewhere.
I'm not going to stay up there forever. I'm as eager to leave as they are eager to get rid of me.
Maybe get an apartment in Springfield and share with Rachel and Ida so you three don't have to drive to work in the morning.
They're nice girls.
Very nice. Maybe get a pet dog. A dachshund. Name him Matt. Smoke all you want in your own apartment. Go to the movies on Saturday nights. Maybe go to some USO dances. Not get involved with any of the boys. No, not Sally.
Is that bad?
No, ma'am, it is not. All the other patients, they said they liked you best. But all the nurses' aides, they were telling me with their eyes, "Don't go away, Matt. Sally will come around."
They enjoyed the game.
Well, so did I, but they weren't telling me to leave.
Well, then I'm telling you to leave. Nothing could come from
you
it,
see,
Matt.
You see, they could tell that I was in love with you. And they thought that you might be in love with me, too. And wouldn't that be a catastrophe?
I don't think I even know what that means. I don't know if you know.
Aside from that, you're afraid that you might love me.
I don't think that's even a desirable state to be in.
Agreed, 100%. All you have to do is say, "No, I am not."
Why don't you just go away? Make us all happier.
I don't think that would make you happier. It wouldn't make me happier. It would be easier. You see, I can take no for an answer. What I can't take is evasion. I can't take I'm scared. I can't take hiding in the closet.
Just put it out of your mind, Matt.
So the future is USO dances, pug dogs, apartments, and drinks with the girls?
It sounds wonderful.
Sally has decided she's going to be an eccentric old maid, and she is going to be one now.
I'm looking forward to it.
Well, see, I'll show you how far Sherlock got. My first solution to this Sally hiding in the closet puzzle.
Kitchen.
Sally hiding in the kitchen was she don't want nothing to do with this Jew type.
You don't think that at all. I'm a liberal Midwestern college graduate. You were very exotic to me. I reread the Old Testament.
Well, I hate to disillusion you, but I did not reread the New Testament. So it is not that. Then Matt thought Sally must be scared because of this Yerman type she can't abide. All the boys are off fighting these Yerman types, and there is one right in the middle of us!
There are old families of German descent here.
Oh, you know nothing about this Freeman. Could be anybody. This enemy might infiltrate the home front, yeah?
Don't. That's creepy.
You should only know. So, she does not think of Matt as a German. Then Matt thought, this Sally puzzle. She's how old? Stop looking at yourself, Matt. It is not only Matt she is not liking. She is well over how old? And all of her friends and all of her relatives got married by what age? And with all the prospering young men around here, somebody...
All the prospering young men are off at war, Matt.
I think we are onto something. Well, then, all the young, handsome, and brave soldiers whom she deals with every day?
They're kids. They're 10 years younger than me. More, most of them.
This has got to be the most peculiar girl that ever was. Who ever heard of such a thing?
Where's the bright red hairnet? Where are the rolled garters on her legs to drive men out of their mind? Why isn't she exposing half her bosom with a plunging neckline like every other female? Here is an attractive, unmarried, not fanatically religious young woman who actually thinks of herself as a human being and not as a featherbed, and you say there is no mystery? Also, I have spoken to the other patients. Some of them are not so young. All of them said, "Are you Sally's beau?" Every time we try to say something sweet, try to get fresh, she always says, "Come on now, I got a beau."
There's time enough for...
There's nothing. We're just having a friendly conversation, Sally. No reason to get upset.
Come on. My life is of no concern to you. We get through the war. There's time to think about the future.
No, no, no. No one thinks like that anymore. Think for today.
Everything's upside down.
No, no. We are not waiting for when Johnny comes marching home again.
I can't hear a word you're saying. You got a thing of blood on your face.
Blood? Where? How did
oh,
I get...
Oh, don't touch it. You said that thing fell on you. Now, don't touch it. Don't... Put your hands down.
What is that?
Never you mind.
What is that? Ow, ow, that stings. What did you put on?
It's gin. Now, you're not hurt. Don't sit down.
No, no, I won't be inoculated. I won't get lockjaw.
I'm sorry to hear it.
Ouch, ouch. I've had a tetanus shot.
I know, because you read in a book how to be a fisherman.
No, well, some knowledge has to be acquired, you know. People aren't born with knowledge of the river, otherwise no one would drown. Ouch! This is a professional nurse's bedside manner? Also, I read. In my job, you have to learn to read very fast because they change the tax laws every week.
One more.
So I read very fast. But I retain nothing, but I read like lightning.
I read very slowly, and I practically memorize every word.
Well, Jack Sprat! Am I okay?
You'll live.
You have sense end for your breath? Oh! Poor Whistler.
If he could see his boathouse now, he'd sing Una furtiva lagrima.
I used to think he made the place for me. I was little when he died, but I thought he built it just the way it is. Falling down. Just like the way people used to make Roman ruins for their gardens. That way, nobody would come down to this place and discover the magic of it, except for me.
It was falling down even then?
It wasn't that long ago. I played in it when I was 8 or 10, and I'm 27 now, so...
Oh, no, you are counting wrong.
I'm what?
You are 31.
I am not 31. What
do you... Oh, she does have a vanity as well as a temper. You are 31 because you were fired from Sunday school on your 28th birthday, and that was 3 years ago.
What?
I have become very good friends with your Aunt Charlotte. You have a counter-spy in your very midst. I didn't tell you. You've been infiltrated. I've come up on you from behind.
When did you talk to Aunt Charlotte?
For a minute today, and for a second, last summer, and every few weeks over the winter on the telephone. Oh. I have never heard of someone being fired from Sunday school before.
I quit. We didn't get along.
That's not the way she said it. She said that the preacher told you should be teaching from the Methodist Reader, not from Thorstein Veblen.
They were having problems with union organizers at the garment factory.
Some of the kids' mothers work there.
And they asked me what was happening.
I like that. And so you read to them from...
The Theory of the Leisure Class.
How much of the garment factory does your family own?
Nearly 25%. Dad and the minister and the newspaper editor all suggested we concentrate on the text. And he who does not work neither shall he eat.
Scare the pants off the sluggards.
Make the unreligious infidels buckle down.
Be good Christian workers.
I also read from St. Augustine.
Profit is a sin.
Businessmen can never enter the kingdom.
He was also a terrible anti-Semite.
Worse, he was Catholic.
Sally, you know that unmarried daughters are supposed to help the menfolk maintain the social status quo?
Make food baskets for the poor.
Keep their mouths shut.
There was a time when Dad had great hopes for me.
Well, no wonder he wanted to kick you out of the house.
You're older than I am.
More than you know, I'm 42.
That's about what I imagined.
Sally, you don't say that, no matter what you think.
Under the draft by the skin of your teeth.
Yes.
You could have volunteered.
Yes?
You been married?
No, ma'am.
Why?
I never asked anyone, and no one ever asked me.
Should have heard the other nurses' aides after you left. They thought you were the bee's knees.
People still say that around here?
They still say cat's pajamas. Only something is wrong. Something's goofy, isn't it? A single man, 42 years old. Doesn't make sense. A good man hasn't made a fool of himself at least once by your age.
Well, puzzles. Why did the chicken cross the road? A man I know says a riddle to me every day. I say, don't tell me, don't tell me, don't tell me. By the end of the day, I say, okay, I give up. Puzzles and jokes.
They couldn't quite put you together, so they decided you weren't quite right. Maybe you had a wife and 6 kids in Germany.
You like jokes? Old Ben Franklin was sitting by his kitchen window flying a kite, and the Mrs. Franklin comes in and says, you need more tail. And Ben Franklin says, that's what I told you this morning, and you told me to go fly a kite.
I heard that before I was 12.
I had never heard that before. Mrs. Blumenfeld from the office told us that yesterday morning.
English wasn't your first language. What was?
Questions and answers. What's the shortest month of the year? May is the shortest month. May has only 3 letters in it.
German? Yiddish?
What was Matthew's first language? Doesn't come out funny. Why should it matter? He can't talk to the old man at the cafeteria in Lithuanian anymore. Not like he used to. Some pieces. The weather is hot today. Yes, the weather is hot today. I read that the Germans infiltrated Russia.
Yes.
Whatever happened to the Russian-German friendship? I yell at him as if he were deaf.
Where were you born?
This is one you haven't heard before.
Where was that sidewalk they skated on?
I've lived in many cities. Dear, we are a lot alike to be so different. We're two such private people. A man I know, I eat at a cafeteria, I talk to a lot of funny guys.
No,
this is
story.
What I came down here to tell you. He said to me that people, that we are eggs.
Who, you and me?
No, all people. He said that people were eggs, individuals. He said that we ought to be careful not to bash into each other too hard and break our shells and never be of any use anymore. Said we were eggs, individuals. He was very protective of his own shell. He said, no one can ever really know what's going on in the other guy's head. We all got 10 tracks going at any given time, and no one really knows what's coming down any given track at any given time, so we never really communicate. So right now I'm talking to you on track number 3, and over on track number 5, I could be thinking any number of things. And when I think you're listening to me, what are you really thinking?
You think he's right or you think he's wrong?
Well, that's 2 ways of looking at it. I told him he's paranoid. I said, you shouldn't work so hard at being, you shouldn't worry so much about being understood. Ought to work at it. I said, well, we have our work cut out for us, don't we? I told him that he was...
What?
Well, it's right there in the analogy, ain't it? What good is an egg? Ought to be cracked or hatched or beat up into something with a lot of other eggs. Then you're cooking. I told him he shouldn't be so worried about getting his yolk broke.
Where were you born?
He didn't much appreciate it either.
Why are you being such a private person? Such an egg?
Where was Matthew born? Rostock? Dansk? Or Kaunas? But probably Kaunas, which later became the capital of...
Lithuania.
What was Lithuania? So, there. Omelette.
When did you come to America?
This is one you haven't heard before. This is a city joke. The Kaiser's architect wanted had an outhouse that he wanted painted and plastered. So he asked for contracts from three different men. A Polish man, an Italian, and a Jew.
Matt.
So the Pole said, well, that job will cost you 3,000 marks. And the Kaiser's architect said, 3,000 marks? How do you figure 3,000 marks? And the Pole said, well, 1,000 for the plasterer, 1,000 for the painter, and 1,000 for me. And so then the Italian says, well, that job will cost you 6,000 marks. And the Kaiser's architect said, 6,000 marks? How do you figure 6,000 marks? And the Italian said, well, 2,000 for the plasterer, 2,000 for the painter, and 2,000 for me. And so the Jew then said, that job will cost you 9,000 marks. And the Kaiser's architect said, 9,000 marks? How do you figure 9,000 marks? And the Jew said, well, 3,000 for you, 3,000 for me, and 3,000 for the Pole.
You said you were German. Why were you born in Lithuania?
Probably Lithuania.
When did you come to America? But did you come with your family? Or don't you know that either?
No, I know. Very well, Miss Sally Talley. There was a Prussian, a Ukrainian, yes? A Prussian, a Uke, a Lat, and a probable Lit who traveled all over Europe together.
Matt, this is maddening. I don't know if this is a story or if this joke.
This is a story that I can tell in the only way that I can tell it. The Prussian had been a soldier, but being Jewish, he could not advance in the Kaiser's army, so he became an engineer.
There's no such thing as a Prussian Jew?
Prussian is how the Prussian thought of himself, and Prussian he was. So he became a wandering engineer. The Kaiser sent the Prussian, the Uke, the Lat, and the probable Lit all over Europe studying engineering wonders, many months in the Swiss mountains watching the building of a funicular, yes?
Yes.
And in the evenings, the Prussian liked to sit stiffly and speak with other stiff Prussian Jews in the cafes of all across Europe. One day, one of the people with whom he spoke was...
Matt, I'm getting confused. Is this a joke, or...?
This is a joke about how the probable Lit came to America that you said that you wanted to hear. So, one of the people with whom he spoke was an inventor named... who remembers such as fame, who had discovered how to get nitrogen out of the air, like magic. So one day, the Prussian, the Uke, the Lat, and the probable Lit lit out for Naples, but they were detained in Nice, where there is a large police force, because people like to get on boats there in order to cross borders. Europe is mostly made up of borders that people get upset when they try to cross. Europe is like the child's game of May I. You know May I?
Captain, may I cross into Yugoslavia? Yes, you may cross into Yugoslavia. Take three scissor steps.
Okay, I take three scissor steps. One, two,
no, Go back to Czechoslovakia. You forgot to say may I.
Who is the Uke and who is the Lat? You're the Lit and your father is the Prussian. Who's the Uke?
This is all on the up and up, Sally. The Uke was married to the Prussian. She said she was Sephardic, but that wasn't true.
Okay, Matt, I want to understand this. Who is the Lat?
The Lat was their daughter, who had been born in Latvia 2 years before the probable Lit had been born, probably in Lithuania.
I didn't know you had a sister.
Turned out to be of little consequence. People in Europe being very wasteful of people.
And your family was detained in Nice?
Yes, by the Nice police, which was very unlucky, as the French are very much the natural enemy of the Prussians, and the French government very much wanted to know from the Prussian engineer what. something he had overheard in a cafe.
How to get nitrogen from the air.
Like magic.
Why?
Everyone was looking forward greatly to the Great War.
This was when?
This was in 1911. The little Lit was 9. And this nitrogen was not used as fertilizer in the fields. This nitrogen was used in the manufacture of gunpowder. So one should be very careful what your friends tell you in cafes. So the French torture the Prussian.
Oh no.
Who, being Prussian and Jewish, says nothing. So then the French decide to torture the lad daughter in order to get the Prussian to speak.
Matt, you don't have to say anything.
The consequence being that the lat fell into a coma from which she did not recover. And the French decide that they had the wrong Prussian, Uke, lat, and probable lit, and let the whole lot of them go. And so then they went to the German authorities, the irony being that the German government reasoned that this gregarious Prussian engineer knew something of very great consequence to the Kaiser.
Oh, no.
As well he did. So they tried to escape across the border to Denmark, but we understand they forgot to say, may I?
They wouldn't kill their own people just because of something they knew they might or might not tell.
They would not consider them their own, of course. And people were not killed in Germany. People were indefinitely detained.
I never heard there were persecutions in the First World War.
I thought you said you reread the Old Testament.
When did he come to America?
Who says the little Lit came to America?
When did he come to America?
Norway to Caracas to America on a banana boat.
By himself? With refugees?
Refugees, smefugees, with his uncle from Lübeck, his wife, and his 4 kids.
Little kids?
What does it matter what size kids? No, not little kids. Grown people. There's always something thrilling about the broad canvas of a European story, isn't there? But I am afraid the little Lit had seen too much. No causes would claim him anymore. No allegiances.
So the Lit didn't volunteer for the army.
Oh, war. What did he know except war? Life was war. War was life. Against the French, he would have almost certainly gone this time. No. The resolve was to never be responsible for bringing into this world another living soul. He would never be responsible for bringing into this world a child to be killed for political purpose. This little boy knew blank about sitting alone without a woman to talk to. So the little Lit was a little crazy, and I'm afraid as he grew older he became a little crazier, but I'm afraid he has witnessed nothing to cause him to alter his conviction. And what woman would be interested in such a grown probable Lit with such resolve? It doesn't matter. He doesn't think about it. The day is over in a second. I spend my life adding figures. It breaks my head.
He does. The Lit.
Does what?
You said I. You mean the Lit. The Lit spends his life adding figures.
Yes, well, I do too. We are a lot alike. We work together.
You've both gone to a lot of work for nothing.
What work? What do you mean?
Or do you naturally invent stories about your sister and your father and your mother being killed by Germans?
One by the French, 2 by the Germans.
You've been talking to Aunt Lottie? Who else have you talked to? Have you talked to people in town? Have you looked in the Lebanon newspaper, the old files? I don't know how detectives work.
Sally, this is bad. I have said something.
Why did you tell me that story?
Because I wanted you to know why I didn't talk to you last year.
That's what you came down here to tell me.
Yes!
Well, you told me. Now I know. Now you can leave.
Sally, I have said something. I do not know what I have said.
You took a calculated risk? It was just... You just miscalculated. You're not good at manipulation. I've been worked over by experts. They're good down here.
Sally, you have been made a mistake. I am not here to...
Get gone now. Leave! Before I hit you with something, you go up to the Barnetts. They'll give you some gas for a couple of coupons.
Now who is making a disturbance?
Get off this property. or get out of my way so I can go up to the house, or I will disturb you, for real.
No one is going anywhere. We have to deal with this before anyone goes anywhere.
I won't be made a fool just because I fell in love again, Matt, and I won't be pushed around again.
Sally, I won't let you go anywhere.
Get out of here!
Did you hear what you just said? Did you listen to yourself?
Buddy! Cliffy!
We could... You are a crazy woman! We both could be shot with that gun! People are... do not yell and scream and kick. People are born with the beautiful gift of reason.
Cliffy!
God, how could such a thing happen? When reason was handed out, did everybody in the Ozarks go on a marshmallow hunt? Are you rational now? Ow! Life is going to be interesting with you. Are you hurt?
No.
My hand is bleeding. Where's that alcohol you said you had hidden? I talked to my aunt and uncle, 70 years old. They tell me, Matt, do not get involved with the Goyim. They have my cousins call me. All the neighbors I haven't heard from in years. I tell them I must live my own life. I come down here protected from tetanus, and here I am getting rabies from an ultimoid.
Why did you tell me that story about your family?
Because you asked me. Why have you never been married? Where were you born? How did you get to this stupid country? Because I am a crazy man. All the nurses' aides say something is wacky with Matt because he has never made a fool of himself over some girl. I say, Matt, come down here. Tell Sally who you really are. For once in your life, risk something. Then you will know you have done all you could do. What do you think she's going to do? Bite you?
Charlotte told you nothing. She may be silly. She may like you.
One does not necessarily follow from the other.
But she doesn't gossip about me. No. No, she told you nothing.
So you say. So I asked Charlotte, Charlotte, Sherlock thinks that there's some deep, dark mystery down here, and Charlotte said, Mr. Holmes, Sally will have to tell you that herself.
There's nothing to tell.
Oh, my goodness, you were just calling for the sheriff because there is a... Oh, the sheriff, they could be down here at any moment.
Oh, they're all listening to the radio.
Oh, saved by Fanny Bryce. Oh, I don't even know how to begin. I'm coming into an unfamiliar church in my underdrawers here.
What are you talking about?
You have never had that dream? Oh, I congratulate you. It is a terrible dream. None of the skills that I have seem appropriate for the situation I find myself in, and I have amazing skills. I could be an attraction at a sideshow. I know all the multiplication tables, up to 75 times 75. Truly, this is something I know. But I feel like Houdini in the iron box under the ice at the bottom of the river. I have forgotten where I've put my handcuffs, the keys. Oh, such a frightening, terrible dream.
One of the boys at the hospital is an artist. He's developed a facility for when a dream starts to go bad, for when it starts to get scary. He, in the dream, changes it all into a drawing. He wads it up and throws it away.
Freud wouldn't like it.
Oh, it'd drive him crazy.
I'm foolish to come down here and insinuate myself, think that of myself as one of the hillbillies. Whoever heard of this Matt Freeman? I don't blame you. I won't be Matt Freeman anymore. I'll join the throng. I'll call myself August Hedgepeth. Sit moonshine over the back of my elbow. Wheat straw out of the gap of my teeth. I'm not cleaning my glasses. I'm fishing for crappie. Bass.
Sunburn.
Oh, heck yes! Only I'm not. I can't even take my shoes off without feeling absurd.
People don't walk around here with their shoes off, sipping moonshine. It isn't really the Hatfields and the McCoys. You know, people who won't go barefoot only do so because they can't afford shoes. Matt,
oh, that's not my name. My name is August. You gotta call me August.
I couldn't possibly.
Well, that's my name as of this very moment.
Matt, you...
Huh? Who? What?
August.
I don't like it. What's that fragrance? What are you wearing?
It isn't me.
Smell.
Honeysuckle.
That's honeysuckle? No wonder they write songs about it. It blooms at night?
No, that's something else. Blooms in the night, in the day, whenever.
It's wonderful.
Well, you've never had to grub it out of a garden.
You know that Missouri folk song?
Lindy, did you smell that honeysuckle vine last night? Honey, it was smelling so sweet in the moonlight.
No, I mean, sure, but I don't know it.
We heard the Lebanon band play it last summer. Isn't it a Missouri folk song?
I don't know. I don't know Missouri folk songs.
Oh God, I lay me down and die. If I could be as sweet as that to you, my little Lindy Lou.
And don't sing. That's ridiculous. My name's not Lindy Lou. It's Sally Talley.
I know I wanted to talk to you about that.
I'm not going to change.
What's wrong? Sally, why is your lip trembling? What's
you
wrong?
You didn't say that. Don't say that.
It's what I want to say.
Well, don't. Talk about your socialism. Talk about your work or something, like you did in your letters.
I don't talk socialism. I don't talk communism. I talk common sense. You'd start talking about isms like they were really something, and you defend them like they were tangible. What are you afraid of? Why do you...
And is that what Buddy was so angry about? An olive? You talking common sense?
No, your brother is a baiter. You want to change the subject? Fine.
What? A what?
A baiter. A baiter. He baits people. Your brother Buddy thinks that if all the factory workers strike for better wages, as they are trying to do in his factory, it'll bring the country to his knees.
It would certainly bring Buddy to his knees, and that's a position with which he's very unfamiliar, believe me.
What are you afraid of?
People are working now, at least.
You want to talk economics? I come down here, I say, this is my life, this is what I want, take it or leave it, and you say, talk economics?
Will there really be strikes after the war's over?
You are playing games, yes?
I don't know what...
You are a peach. Yes, they will strike. When they come home, they'll strike. Everybody from soda jerks to grease monkeys. It'll give them the illusion that the system is working.
I think people are afraid to admit it, but they're worried about what might happen when the boys come home.
Down here, they're afraid to admit it? I'm glad to hear that. It shows humility, and humility is good for the soul. Over in St. Louis, people are shaking in their beds at night. Headlines in the newspapers. One businessman said that the war would have to last another 2 years or the nation would never recover.
They're afraid there'll be another depression.
They who?
They? Who do we ever mean when we say they?
A man I know says they-sayers are all liars. No, it won't happen.
Why should it be different this time?
It will be different. It won't happen again. Roosevelt himself will be handing out lollipops.
I don't know why you're saying that.
There is more money saved up now than there ever was before the war, burning a hole in people's pockets. How many people have bought war bonds? 85 million people. How much money is in savings banks? $130 billion. People will be working and spending and building. End of financial exhibition. Sideshow is over. Why did I come down here? You are not going to be honest with me.
Honest about what?
Honest about you and me, about Sally and Matt. I'm not intent to stand here and talk about economics. What will happen after the war? Why should there be an after the war?
I was being perfectly honest with
perfectly
you.
Perfectly honest and perfectly evasive. Perfectly mysterious and perfectly frightened out of your wits.
You know something, baby? You dames are all alike. You yellow. You got a yellow streak a mile wide running down the middle of your back.
Is that supposed to be Cagney?
Oh my gosh, Cagney? No, that was Bogart again. You have absolutely no sense of flattery.
Well, we're all yellow, huh? You know that many women? Oh, you can make a generalization like that?
Gosh, no. Is that how you're going to be? Jealous of something you don't even want? No, I know no other women. What I said here today to you, I have never before said in my life, for the same reason that you say nothing to anyone. Because we're all afraid that we'll be cracked. I really do believe that everyone thinks that they're eggs. We all have... Who is the Eggman? All the king's horses, all the king's...
Humpty Dumpty.
We all have a Humpty Dumpty complex. So I take my big chance. I come down here. I tell you, Sally, I am in love with, for the first time in my life, with a girl who sees the world exactly as I say it. I say, Sally, I am sorry. I will not have children, but if there is a life for the two of us, will you have me? And you scream, and you kick, and you yell bloody murder, and you breathe in and out. What is it called? Breathing.
Hyperventilate.
You hyperventilate, and then say, Matthew, talk finance? Oh, boy, oh, boy.
You can come with me to the road. I'll get you some gas. I'll go in the yard by myself.
The car isn't out of gas.
What is it out of?
Hope. The car is out of hope. The car is in fine working condition. I turn the key, it goes on. I turn it off, it stops. I never said that the car was out of gas. I said that it requires gas to run. You assumed it was out of gas. I wasn't talking to Buddy about isms up at the house. I was talking to him about you and I in the boathouse last summer.
Oh, my God. Oh! Oh, my God!
No, don't. You get that sheriff down here. You'll drown out Fibber McGee.
You didn't.
No, shh. You'll be heard across the bandstand. Oh. We can sit and watch the band play. Don't you want to see the band play at Whistler's band show? We can... Oh, so the evening won't be a complete waste?
You didn't.
It's okay. We can watch. Maybe we can see the fireworks.
They won't have fireworks. You can hear the music from here. Now, Matt, you have no idea how prejudiced Buddy and Olive are, really.
You kidding me? I don't think that they'll allow you to sleep in his house once Buddy tells him. Also, your Aunt Charlotte thinks that they might shave off your head.
Aunt Lottie put you up to this?
She said that you wanted to get out of the house and you lacked courage. She's a very bold strategist.
You told her about last summer?
No, she told me. You told Rachel. Rachel told her cousin Rose, and Rose told your Aunt Charlotte.
I'll brain them, everyone.
Have you been listening to anything that I've been telling you?
What? No, Matt, I told you. Put it out of your head.
You are hard. You are tough.
Well, I can't think about it now.
Well, I think you better.
There's no place to go, or I'd be out of there, Matt.
There is a hospital in St. Louis. St. Louis's St. Anne's. They're dying for help. You could work there.
Too long a drive.
Well, it just so happens that I have an apartment 3 blocks away.
You have room for 3 nurse's aides?
I rescind the offer. Well, you like St. Louis? The Browns, you never know. The Cardinals are okay. We could go to a game, watch the Cooper brothers.
You can see I don't want you to talk like that.
I hear you saying that, but I think I see something different. You're not afraid of me. Right now, are you afraid of me?
I've never been afraid of you.
Then forget everything I said. I did not ask Sally to marry me. Sally did not tell me not to sing. We're just two friends, looking over the river, at the moon and the trees, in the water. Okay? So I ask you, what did Aunt Charlotte mean when she said that there is something Sally needs to tell you that only she can say?
Now, it was a long time ago.
So, you're 31. How long ago could have that have been?
It was another life, really.
So what happened in this other life?
Say I was disappointed in love. It was a long time ago. I was another person.
No, I don't believe disappointed in love.
It was more of a financial arrangement than anything.
Well, disappointed in a financial arrangement, I understand.
I was engaged to Harley Campbell, his dad.
I don't believe it.
You don't even know who he is.
He was the boy in the field yelling, "You tell him, Buddy, you tell him, Buddy."
Well, he used to be very good looking.
I don't believe that either.
He was a guard on the basketball team, and I was a cheerleader. We grew up together. We were the two richest families in town. We were golden children. Dad owned a quarter of the garment factory, and Harley's dad owned a third. These two great families were to be united in one happy factory. We used to walk around the plant holding hands, waving to all the girls. They loved us.
The youth,
and
the beauty,
the money. The workers demanded a showdown to discuss their demands, and Dad pulled us right out on a platform, right into the middle of the meeting, and said, Do you love them or do you love them? Here's the future of the country. Now back to work. They still don't have a union.
So how did it happen that Sally was disappointed in love?
It all became academic. The depression happened. Maybe we didn't look so golden. The factory nearly closed.
I know the depression came, so how did it happen that Sally was disappointed in love?
I was sick for a long time. I got TB, and I had to miss school. I didn't graduate until a year after Harley did. It was a good excuse to drift apart.
So?
So, Harley went to Princeton, got engaged to a girl from New Jersey, and his father killed himself.
Because he got engaged to a girl from New Jersey?
Because by then it was 1931. He was in debt. He thought he would lose the factory. He didn't know how to live poor.
So?
Harley quit school. Buddy and Harley and Dad worked at the factory trying to save it. They're doing fine now.
I know, a government contract for army uniforms. So?
Harley's wife left him 8 years ago, and he remarried a girl from Rogersville.
That's the truth? The whole truth and nothing but the truth, so help you, Hannah?
Yes.
You're real cute. Might as well go off and get the gas for, don't you think?
You're not out of gas.
Well, maybe I am. Maybe I lied.
Well, if that's what it takes.
You know what I'm thinking? Over on track number 9, maybe this Sally girl isn't who I thought she was after all.
Maybe not.
May not be. Maybe not. What kind of an answer to a riddle is that? What changed to make this golden girl the embarrassment of the family? What into a radical old maid who was fired from Sunday school? Why would this nice Harley leave you after all this time when you had come down with such a romantic disease? You see, I am a logical person, and I need things laid out for me, and that is not logical.
His family didn't want him to marry me, obviously.
So, what? You were not good enough for him?
Come on.
What?
Don't do that. Yes.
So, Mr. Campbell was deeply in debt, and he was overextended, but the partner who is rich, his daughter gets TB, and suddenly the wedding is off?
I don't know.
Harley is the richest boy in town, you said?
Yes.
And you were the richest girl in the countryside. This is the match of a decade. The bell should be ringing for such a match.
Well, they didn't.
When the depression comes, rich families must pool their resources.
They didn't feel that way.
So, the Campbells are a large Missouri family, yes? 15 little Campbells?
No.
No, just Harley, his 3 brothers, and 1 sister?
No.
Harley and his only brother?
Harley and his sister.
Harley is the only son of a prominent LeClaide County family.
Yes.
So why would he not want their only child to marry this popular cheerleader Talley girl who he had been seeing for 3 years?
They didn't like me.
So he had been dating you all this time over their protests?
Not on your life.
No, because Harley didn't do anything beyond his parents' wishes.
No.
But you didn't graduate with Harley. You were delayed a full year.
That's beginning to hurt.
You're pulling. I'm not pulling. Why were you not good enough for him?
I got sick.
So you got sick, you got TB, and you had to go to Arizona where you spent the rest of your life?
No.
You gave this Harley TB and he went to Arizona and was never heard from again?
The TB was not serious. There were complicating circumstances that kept me from being in school.
Complicating circumstances? You had pockmarks on your face and no one wanted to see you anymore.
You might say that.
Harley was repulsed by the sight of you.
No, Matt. I was in the hospital for a month. I had a fever.
Harley had a morbid fear of hospitals. I'm getting a fever. Who's getting a fever?
They didn't want it.
But your dad insisted.
He didn't want it either.
You were white. You were pale and white and would not look good in a wedding dress. Is that it? You were a tramp and a vamp and would ruin the reputation of this prominent family.
He was the heir. He had to carry on the family name.
You were irresponsible. You had crippling kleptomania and could not be trusted around the family money.
I got sick. I had a fever.
You were delirious. You were drunken. And no family would want their only child to be married to this woman.
I was sick for a year.
You were not sick. You were in. You were away. Why did you go away?
I was in the house.
Why were you in the house for a year?
I had a fever.
You had not have a fever. You had disgraced yourself.
I had a pelvic infection.
Is that what you told everyone?
They didn't know what was wrong with me.
Why were you away?
I had a fever. They couldn't break it.
What were you hiding?
They couldn't break the fever.
What were you
By the time they did, it didn't matter. Because it had eaten out my insides. I couldn't bear children. I can't have children. Don't let go of me.
What do you mean?
I couldn't have children.
Sally, I didn't know.
Go away. Go away.
No. It's okay. It's okay.
I've had no child. There was no scandal. I was no longer of value to the merger.
It's okay. It's okay.
Stop. That's what I tell all the boys in the hospital. It's okay, only they're dying of blood poisoning. Don't come for me. I'm fine. Blast you. Let go.
I thought you had a child by somebody else. I didn't know. You're so crazy.
I've had no child. I only wish I had.
This is a result of the TB?
The infection descended to the fallopian tubes. It's not uncommon with women at all. So there could be no heir to the garment empire. It was all such a great dance. Everyone came to the hospital. Everyone said it made no difference. By the time Harley graduated, the Campbells weren't even speaking to the Talleys. By then, Dad was looking at me like I was a broken swing. It's a very interesting perspective.
Did you think your Aunt Charlotte had told me you can't have children and I just made up the story of my life just to tease you?
Possibly.
Eggs! 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 We're eggs! We are all so terrified, but still we hope. And you put on this dress. Did you tell the people who you work with that you were seeing me?
No.
And look at me. 5 years I wear the same tie to work. I have never bought a new tie for myself. I come down to see Sally and I buy a new tie. You see how corruption of principle begins?
I had nothing to do with that.
This dress I have never seen before. Is it new?
Yes. It's not a big deal.
It is a very big deal. It is the new deal. It is a very, very big deal.
You didn't even say you liked it.
I like it. I love the dress. This past winter in St. Louis, I was in a terrible quandary. It is not that I thought that I could be happy, or it is not that I have been happy or have not been happy, but that I have not thought that I could be happy. But this past winter, I was terribly, terribly unhappy. I had fallen for a girl. And I knew I could not give her the life that she would surely expect with a child and family. Do you see what has happened? Some mischievous angel has looked down at us, living 200 miles apart, and said, you know what would be a real kick in the head? Let's send Matthew on a vacation to Lebanon.
You believe in angels?
I most certainly do. Her name might be Lottie Talley, maybe. We missed your band play.
They'll play all evening.
We'll go to St. Louis tonight. We'll leave the car in town. We'll take
Matt, it's crazy to be talking like that. We're practically middle-aged.
So? We'll go up to St. Louis tonight, leave the car in town, and take the midnight bus.
I'll be up in a week or so.
I'll take a hotel in Lebanon and wait.
You have work tomorrow.
So what?
We'll go tonight.
Lindy Lou, Lindy Lou, oh God, I'd lay right down and die. If I could be as sweet as that to you, my little Lindy Lou. We live in such a beautiful country, such a beautiful countryside. Will you miss it?
Yes.
Me too. We'll come down once a year so we don't forget.
All right.
And so all's well that ends. Right on the button. Good night.
Don't go down.